Welcome to My Long Island TV. From Manhasset to Montauk, we have traveled our communities to bring you the following events. I'm your host, Waldo Cabrera. My Long Island TV starts now.
Hello, I'm John Owens, editor-in-chief of Anton Community Newspapers, a group of 18 newspapers covering Long Island. Today, our guest is Adam Haber, candidate for the state 7th Senate District. You're a graduate of SUNY Albany.
I am.
You have a master's from LIU Post.
I do.
In government and political science.
Absolutely.
You're a successful businessman. Okay, now, running for state senate, why you?
Well, I started first in community service when our superintendent stole $11.2 million in 2004, 2005. And my business background enabled me to really help our community recover from a terrible loss. We went from one of the highest tax districts in all of Nassau County. Since I've been on the board, this is my sixth year, we have the lowest tax levy increase of any full district in all of Nassau County, which is a huge accomplishment. We've averaged only about a little over 1% a year. We've retained all our teachers and we've expanded services.
What are some other big issues in this election?
Well, the big issues, everybody's fully aware of that Long Island is just a place that's too expensive because of the incredibly high taxes. When you knock on doors, which I do almost every single day, it's, I love it here, but I can't afford to live here. The tax burden is overwhelming.
You know about school taxes. More than 80% of the school budget comes directly from property taxes.
It's about two-thirds.
What can we do about that?
Well, one of the things I did do is I wanted to make sure that we're running as efficiently as possible. That's how I helped in Roslyn. I knew I could take it to a larger audience because we refinanced our debt. I created a project where we had intermunicipal busing. I helped start a foundation. We did community purchasing with some of our districts. I created a consortium, which I plan on doing with all the 11 full school districts, including the two that are partially in our district, to help save money. There's power in numbers, and we're not using our leverage. We're all going out for services individually. There's so much you can do, and I feel I could save tens of millions of dollars for our community in taxes just by using the practices I learned when I was in the private sector.
Creating jobs. Now, I know when you were running for the Democrat nomination for county executive, you spoke a lot about creating jobs.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You had some very clever ideas. Would you go on to those?
There's some things that we can do that aren't that expensive that could add a lot of value. And I'll give you two examples of missed opportunities. When The Great Gatsby was filmed, and they filmed it on the North Shore of Long Island, we have a very strong film industry here. They should have leveraged that and had a huge festival around that, gotten people to come from the city. The mayor had a worldwide tourism drive, and they've doubled the amount of tourists in New York City. They had 50 million tourists last year. I want to bring them here. The Belmont Stakes, right? Third leg of the Triple Crown. They had a parade, which was put on by the community, which was great. But if you think about the Rose Bowl and the people who come out and spend the weekend, I mean, you could have a countywide triathlon would draw hundreds of thousands of people, even a statewide, I'm sorry, an island-wide triathlon. Then they'll go in our restaurants, they'll go in our hotels, they'll shop in our stores. And most of our revenue here is driven locally by not just state taxes, not just by school taxes, but by sales tax.
Sure.
And unless we do something to stimulate the economy, we're going in the wrong direction. There hasn't been a large company move here in the last 30 years.
Well, how could you get big companies to move here? Because with the tax burden and such, that's an issue.
My background will speak the language. I mean, most politicians are lawyers, right? And being a lawyer is an important thing, especially when you're drafting laws. But there are very few businessmen in government. And I speak their language. I've done business overseas in Asia. Everybody wants to come here. They want to come to the United States. I've already spoken to the Better Business Bureau in New York City. I've spoken to some of the consulates. They all come through there looking for jobs and looking to bring resources here. I'm going to be the first guy there. I'm going to say, look at our great schools, look at our beaches, look at our transportation to the city. This is where you want to be. It's the hot spot not only in the country, but I think the number one destination in the world.
Let's talk about women's rights.
Women's equality is a big issue in my campaign. I'm pro-choice. My opponent is not. It's very clear. We make no bones about that. And I follow the governor's plan. There's 10 points to it. There's agreement on most of the points. But it's like building a house without windows. I mean, I want all 10 points. Women should be as equal and have their own health care choices. It's their call.
In a nutshell, what solace can you give to people who live in what has to be the most taxed area in the country?
The tagline of my campaign is taxpayers are hurting, help is on the way. The way you reduce the tax burden is by expanding the economy. If there's more economic activity, there's more sales tax, more businesses are here, people invest more, more buildings, more real estate taxes. If we don't do that, there'll be no help. And I really feel I'm probably the best shot on Long Island as a pro-development business guy who knows how to do it, who's done it, and who knows how to do it to really help relieve the tax burden.
Thank you very much. I'm John Owens, editor-in-chief of Anton Community Newspapers, and I'd like to thank Adam Haber for coming by today and discussing his candidacy for the 7th Senate District.
Well, thanks for having me. It was great.